Look at how stunning that is. Oh my God. Hi you guys, welcome back to the Clean Beauty Code. I'm so excited for this video because we're doing a sale video. We are talking about the Sephora sale and my recommendations, and I'm just gonna jump right into the video because first of all, I talk too much, and also these videos are always so long and I wanna try and keep it short. So if you're excited for this video and more videos like this, then please like and subscribe. Also leave a comment down below on other sale videos you wanna see, gift guide videos you wanna see. Let me know down below, and without further ado, let's get into the Sephora sale recommendations video. Sephora sale recommendations, let's jump right in. First, I'm gonna do it by category. So I'm gonna do like makeup tools, and then we're gonna go into hair and all that jazz. So let's jump right in. First, we're gonna start with brushes. Now, the first brush I'm gonna recommend is this one from Hourglass. I'm a really big fan. This is their dual-ended powder brush. I use this for foundations, get the foundation all in it. I use it for powders. I use it for blush, bronzer. This is a multi brush, and this is definitely one to grab during the Sephora sale because they are, Hourglass brushes are pricey, but they are 100% worth it. Then another Hourglass brush that I love is this one. This is their concealer brush. This is great. It blends out concealer seamlessly. Incredible. Then I want to talk about this brush here. This is another brush that's kind of multi-use for me. I can blend foundation with this. This is the It Cosmetics Heavenly Luxe number 7 brush. I use this, I even use this for concealer, blush, bronzer. A lot of the time I'll blend my foundation out with it. This is such a good multi-use brush. I feel like multi-use brushes are the best. This is great. Then I also have this one. Now this is not necessarily something you need in your collection, but this is a nose contour brush, and I love this. I don't really contour my nose, but I love it to bring bronzer down the sides of my nose because it kind of, I like bronzer down my nose, but it's really hard to get it right, and this just makes it easy. And if you struggle with nose contour, or you just want something, oh, my dog's hair is on this, if you want something that help you like put bronzer down your nose and blend it out, this is great. This blender side is so good. Then we have a whole section of brushes. The Sephora Pro brushes are incredible. I love these, and they blend everything like a dream. And so I'm gonna shout out the ones I have that I really enjoy. So this one's the 59. This one I like to use for bronzer, powder, all of that. Then this is my most used blush brush. This is the 93. Look how faded that is. 93. Then this is the 96. Wait, is it? Yeah. Right on it. This is the 96. This is also a blush brush. I also use it just for blending the edges of my blush or around my face. This is another blush brush. This is the 99. This is great for apples of the cheeks and just, oh, this is great. And this is also really nice for blending. You can use these brushes really for anything. And I also have this brush here. This is their 56. And this is really nice for placing. I don't really contour my face because I look a little crazy with contour. But placing contour down, this is so nice. This really gets in there and does its job. It's also really nice for just blending around other things around the face. It's nice. And it's dense enough, but it's not doing too much. And then we have this. This is the Sephora concealer brush. This is the 71. This is kind of a kitten paw style brush. This is a great alternative to the Hourglass one. I prefer the Hourglass one over this concealer brush. However, I love this concealer brush. You cannot go wrong. Next up in tools, eyelash curler. Now, everyone kind of has their own favorite depending on your eye shape. For me, the Shiseido one is the one that I love. I know so many people love the Tweezerman one too, but this one for me is the best, and this is a really nice pickup during the sale. I just love it. Now we're moving on to actual products. So first, the LYS Beauty setting spray. I'm picking another one of these up during the sales because I get through this so quickly. I love this. It sets your makeup in place, melts the powder down really nicely. It's really nice to also spray on your face before foundation. It makes my makeup last a lot longer. I feel like it does control oil a little bit. It has a nice finish and dry down. This is great. I'm a really big fan of this, and I know a lot of other people are too. This is really worth getting during the sale because I don't know about you, but I get through setting spray very quickly. Now we're gonna move on to powder. And the first one I wanna recommend is the Amie Cole setting powder because it's my favorite. It is by far just, it sets your makeup really well. If you don't like, oh, I have a dog hair floating. Oh my God. If you don't like setting powder and you don't like the way it feels and you don't like how matte it can be, this is great because it's more of a soft matte in my opinion. It doesn't feel tight. It doesn't make my under eyes uncomfortable. This is incredible and makes my makeup last really well and look just seamless and flawless and everything. Now, I was unsure of which one of these to recommend for like a pressed powder, so I'm gonna recommend both. One, for me, is better than the other, but I feel like price point-wise, I gotta suggest both. So the Tower 28 one is great. I love this. This reminds me a lot of the Charlotte Tilbury powder in just the way that it kind of sits under your eyes and looks and wears throughout the day. This is amazing. I have the pink shade. It's very brightening. I love this. If you're looking for a brightening powder, this is definitely nice to check out, and it's not uncomfortable under the eyes. And I know a lot of people don't like powder under their eyes. I'm one of those people. This is amazing. And then this is a very expensive powder, but for me, this is incredible. The Westman Atelier setting powder. Now this I have in my bag as a blotting powder. I actually just dropped it. So this is a little broken. I have the translucent shade, but they also have pink and other shades in it. I love this. I like to use this with just a triangle puff and just set around my face, and it blurs, it does all the stuff, makes my makeup look incredible all day. It is very expensive, so it's definitely worth getting during the sale. However, if you're like absolutely not price-wise, the Tower 28 is great as well. Now we're gonna move on to brows, and first we're gonna talk brow gel. Now normally I would recommend the Rose Inc. brow gel, but I haven't gotten a new brow gel from them since they were bought, so I don't know if the formula's changed. So until I grab another one and test it out and try, I'm just not gonna recommend that one. However, that one is great. The other one I would recommend is the Kolfi one. This is really nice, beautiful hold, doesn't flake, holds in place all day. The brushes or kind of combs, whatever you want to call them, are wonderful. Now for brow pencil, I have two recommendations kind of depending on what you want. So No One Shocked by this, the Westman Atelier brow pencil. I wear the shade Bark in this. This is a great brow pencil. I do think if you have thinner brows, this might not be one that you love as much, just because I'm not saying you can't pinpoint, you can, but because it's a little, it's more slanted and not as quite pinpointy, but you can pinpoint with the tip, and I do that all the time. But this might not be for everyone because of that, but it lasts really long, wears beautifully throughout the day, incredible. The next one is actually a new one, but I'm absolutely obsessed with it, and I feel like no one's gonna be shocked if you've watched any of my recent videos. The Merit Beauty brow pencil is incredible. It glides on, it lasts all day. They're beautiful. I have the shade Dark Brown, I believe. A dark brown. It's kind of like a gel consistency, but when you apply it, it doesn't feel like a gel consistency. It's incredible. I'm a really big fan. Next up, we're talking primer. Now, I don't really use primer that much unless I'm going to like an event or something like that, but I do have an oily T-zone. So when I know I'm gonna be in a situation where we're sweating out or it's a long day, I'm in a wedding or something like that, the Blot and Blur from Nude Sticks is just, it's everything to me. I have a backup of this. So this is a stick and you just kind of place it and I just kind of tap it in the areas that I need oil controlled and I'm good to go. And it makes me so much less oily throughout the day and controls oil throughout the day. It's incredible. Now for kind of a base product, illuminating product, I feel like no one's gonna be shocked by this. These are incredible. So these are from Westman Atelier. I have two shades out of three. These are their illuminating glow drops, and I have Peau de Peche, Peau de Soleil. I mix them together. Sometimes I wear them on their own. Sometimes I mix them with foundation, with face creams. You can do a lot with these. They really feel like skincare. A lot of the time I just wear them as my base product and my skin looks incredible, and I love how healthy they make my skin look. I am a really big fan of these. Now we're gonna move on to concealer. Now, first concealer I wanna recommend is this foundation concealer stick. I mean, you can use it as a foundation and it's perfectly fine as a foundation. However, I prefer this for covering hyperpigmentation around the face. This is incredible. I put it on, let it sit for like 30 seconds, and then I blend it out, and it really does such a good job of covering hyperpigmentation and acne marks. This is totally fine to wear under the eyes. I prefer a liquid concealer under my eyes, so this isn't one I grab for under the eyes a lot. However, this is great. It doesn't really crease on me, and it doesn't make my mascara run. Some concealers just make your mascara run. This one does not make mine. Now we're gonna move on to liquid concealers. The first one I feel like no one shot by. The Colfi concealer, I love this. It is an incredible concealer. It's so comfortable to wear. It looks so beautiful under the eyes. It has a little bit of dew to it, but it's not like wet looking under the eyes. It has great medium coverage. I wear the shade Mango Drop in this. It is incredible. Anyone that's watched this channel knows I love this and I talk about it all the time. This is an incredible concealer. Next up, we have the Iris and Romeo concealer, which I feel like is not gonna shock anyone. I am absolutely obsessed with this concealer. It does crease, it wears beautifully on the face, it has beautiful medium coverage. You can kind of get maybe a little medium plus coverage. I wear the shade 7 in this. I also have the shade 6 and 5 because I have a problem, you know. And the problem is me, I'm the problem. But this is an incredible concealer and I love the coverage and wear, and it is so comfortable and it doesn't really look like makeup under the eyes. And then I have one more concealer recommendation just in case you want something that works for pinpointing around the face and for concealing your under eyes, and it is the CL concealer. I love this. I've done a full review recently on it, so I'm not gonna jab on, but it's great. I think I have this shade 13N. Yeah, the shade 13N, this is amazing. Now we're moving on to true, like, kind of complexion products, and I wanna do foundation first. The House Labs foundation. I love this foundation. It is beautiful. It looks incredible on the face. It just is amazing. I wear the shade 330 medium cool in this, and it has beautiful coverage, but it doesn't look like makeup on the skin. When I did blend this with a sponge, I didn't love the way that it looked on my skin. I prefer my fingers or a brush with this, but this is a wonderful, wonderful foundation, and I feel like it's one that is definitely worth getting during the sale. And for a tinted sunscreen, there's so many great options out there, but this is the one I had to go with because it's the one I always kind of go back to and love. The CL one is great too. However, this one beats it out a little bit. So this is the Tower 28 tinted sunscreen. I have two shades, the shade 40 and 45. And I mix them together a lot of the time for undertone sake, because sometimes it's a little too neutral or a little too warm. It's like the perfect mix. And then in winter, I'm usually 40 for the most part, but these are amazing, beautiful coverage. And you don't get too dewy or anything like that. And I don't get flashback, which is amazing. You cannot go wrong with these. They are so nice. Then I feel like this next one isn't gonna shock anyone. The Westman Atelier, their complexion drops. I love this. I wear the shade X in this, which I believe is the number 10. And it just gives me the most beautiful complexion. I always get compliments when I wear this. And if you have oily skin, this might not be for you. For me, I have an oily T-zone. It's totally fine. I just set my face with powder, but I set my face with powder most days. But it's just something to note that this might get a little too dewy on you. But also sometimes it just depends on your makeup prep. So if I do use the nude sticks underneath, I'm totally fine. This is really nice. Now we're gonna move on to bronzer. And we have a couple of options here depending on what you like. I feel like the first one is not gonna shock anyone. It is the Westman Atelier, their contour bronzer stick. I really love this. I have the shade Truffle in this. I also have the shade Biscuit. Biscuit, I sometimes will mix with Truffle to get a little bit more of a true contour shade. This is a good bronzer shade for me. It has nice, it like nice, like natural finish. It has nice pigmentation, but it's not overly pigmented. It blends out like a dream. It is really, really easy and nice to wear. And this is one that if you have events or anything like that, this is definitely the recommendation. Next up, we have something that is a little bit creamier, a little bit more on the dewy side, and has a bigger breadth of shade options. The LYS Beauty Bronzer Stick. I feel like no one's shocked by this. I love this. I wear the shade Harmony in this. This is a great bronzer. It blends like a dream. It's pigmented, but it blends like a dream. And so if you feel like you over applied it, it does blend out easily enough where you're not stuck. It's incredible. It wears beautifully. I wear the shade Harmony. I don't know if I said that, so I'm gonna say that again. I could go to the shade Courage if I wanted, but I kind of like my bronzer to be a little bit more mellow. I don't like it to be as dark, but the shade Courage is great, and I really like that. Next up, we have a powder bronzer, and it is the one from House Labs. I love this powder formula. This is the shade Medium Level 7. This, first of all, very little bit goes a long way with this, which is amazing. And it blends like a dream. It really reminds me of the butter bronzer from Physicians Formula. If you like in the way that it blends and just kind of disappears into the skin, but not the color disappears, the powder disappears. It's incredible. Now we're gonna move on to blush, and we have a bunch of options depending on what you like. So my first one is this from Amique. I love this blush. So this is their multi-stick, specifically the shade Dune is my favorite, but all the shades are stunning. And this is just the most beautiful. I mean, look at this. Look how beautiful that shade is. Are you kidding me? It's just the most beautiful, easy to blend, pigmented but not overly pigmented blush. You literally can't go wrong with it. It is amazing. Next up, we have one that I feel like it's not going to shock anyone. The Say Beauty Do Blushes. I actually have all of them except one because it's way too light for me. This formula is amazing. It lasts really long, blends like a dream. These are kind of my most grabbed shades right now. So this one is Cutie, then we have Spicy. Is that Spicy? Yes, yeah, Spicy, Chili, and then Rosy. And I love these. I like to mix them together. I like to wear them on their own. They just do it for me. They're incredible. I know so many people love this formula as well. And for true like no makeup makeup days where I just want a little bit of something, it is the Merit Beauty blush. I love this formula. And this one is the shade Beverly Hills. I love this. I will put this on my cheeks, just blend it out quick and be out the door. And it's very subtle, not subtle where it's like disappears and completely sheer, but it's a subtle blush. It looks really natural. It's incredible. Now we're moving on to powder blushes, and I have two recommendations. The first one is the House Labs blush, specifically the shade, but all the shades are absolutely stunning, but specifically the shade. This is the shade Fire Moon, and this is the most beautiful shade, and I feel like so many people would love this. I also love the shade Pomelo Peach and the shade Hibiscus Haze. And I think those are the only two shades, other shades that I have, but this is incredible. And the matte formula is so nice. It sits on top of powders, on top of creams really well. It is really, really nice. And then the true powder love of my life, the Bare Minerals Bronzer. I have four shades. I have the shade, this one is Kiss of Pink and Kiss of Mauve. I also have Kiss of Rose and Kiss of Copper. These are incredible. If you like the Hourglass ambient lighting blushes, these are great. They kind of remind me of those in the fact that they're not glittery, but they give you a sheen and a really healthy looking cheek. They're amazing. They're very pigmented, but not too pigmented. You're not stuck type pigmented, but they are pigmented. And they're just, I mean, I talk about these all the time, so I'm gonna stop talking about them, but they're amazing. Now we're gonna move on to mascaras, and I have a couple recommendations. My expensive recommendation is the Westman Atelier, their mascara. This is their I Want You mascara. It is incredible. They have one in a gold tube too. That one's fine, but this one stands out. It is amazing. I'm actually wearing it today. Wait, actually, am I? Yeah, I'm wearing it today. I had to double check. Yeah, I'm wearing it today. I love this mascara. It wears beautifully throughout the day. I am such a big fan. And next up, I have two. They're kind of tied for me. One etches the other one out a little bit. But I love both. So we have the Tower 28 mascara and the Ilia mascara. They're limitless. I've talked about both of these a ton, especially the Ilia. The Ilia is incredible. This one I always have to have a backup of. So of the two, the Ilia one etches out the Tower 28 one. However, they're both great formulas, and the Tower 28 one I've recommended to a ton of people who kind of struggle with mascara working for them if they have sensitive eyes. And they have no complaints with this. It's a really, really nice mascara. Next up, we have mascara, and I have two recommendations. The first one is the Merit Beauty, their matte eyeshadow in kind of this pot. This is the shade Run. They do not move. They last all day. And they dry down. So don't wait too long while using them. Kind of do your thing. Blend and then move on to the next eye. Don't do place on both eyes because this does dry down. This works great as an eyeliner. This looks great underneath the eye. Blends really nicely. It's a very, very long wear mascara eyeshadow, and it's incredible. And right now, I do love an eyeshadow palette, but right now I'm really loving kind of individual shadows as opposed to like a full palette, which is why I'm recommending individual shadows today. This is really nice, and I think I'm going to grab one more shade in this during the sale. And then up next, speaking of doesn't move, doesn't crease, does not budge, the Koolfi eyeshadows. Oh my god, I'm obsessed with these. They are so incredible. So I have two shades. Oh, I want to make sure that this. So this one is Satara Sparkles. It is just so stunning. It has the most beautiful, like, pink tone, but it's not too pink. I've done a full look with this, and it's so wearable. And then their newest shade I grabbed, the shade Sauna Sauna. Look how beautiful that is. Oh my god, I'm obsessed with it. Let me just do a little swatch for you so you can see. Look at how stunning that is. Oh my god, what? Look at that. It literally is the most beautiful shade ever. It is, and a very little bit of this goes a long way. Like, you need to, and honestly, maybe tap off on your hand because a very little bit of this goes a long way. It's incredible. Again, it does not crease. I have creasy eyelids, so I always in general need to wait and tap out whatever I have on my lid, even if I'm wearing a, primer. A lot of the time I just have to tap it out because I don't know, my eyelids are creasy. This does not crease on me. It's incredible, and it does not move. I highly, highly recommend checking them out. It's just amazing, and they have a bunch of beautiful shades. Now we are going to move on to eyeliner. Now, if you want one that literally doesn't move ever, this one from Koolfi. This eyeliner does not move. You put it on and it stays. You're in a hurricane, it stays. You're deep diving in the ocean, it stays. It is so long wearing. And I generally have issues with eyeliner sometimes staying. And this one is incredible, and it really doesn't move. And I also am loving the Kosas eyeliner. This is great. This is great for tight lining. They have a lot of great shade options. I like that they have multiple brown options. This is incredible. This is the shade Depth, I believe. I also have one other one. Yeah, this is the shade Depth. I love this. I tight line with this. I use it on my lower lash line. I didn't tell you the shade in the Koolfi. The Koolfi one is just their brown shade. I believe they only have one. Now we're gonna move on to lips. And I have two lip liners I'm recommending. The first one is the Tower 28 lip liner. I love this. And it's also, you can use it, it's a multi liner. So you can use it on your eyes. You can use it to use freckles. This is the shade Draw Me. Incredible. Look how beautiful and dark this shade is. Oh geez, I'm dropping things left and right. It's just so beautiful. It's dark, but it isn't too dark, but it has depth to it. I don't know, I'm obsessed with this. It's amazing. And then I also really love the Ami Colet lip liner. This does not move. This is so beautiful. I love the shade. It's so beautiful. Oh, I didn't say the shade name. I believe it's Petite Cola or Cola. Petite Cola. This is a beautiful shade. I love this. And does not move when it's on your lips. It it's so long wearing. Next, we're talking lipsticks, and I have two recommendations. One is this one, the Mera Beauty lipstick, in both the matte and their non-matte. I love this formula. These formulas in general are great. I have the shade Equestrian in the, wait, is it Equestrian? Yeah, Equestrian in the matte one. This is a nice soft matte lipstick. It is stunning. I've tried this on camera. This is an absolutely beautiful shade. You can't go wrong. And they have a bunch of beautiful shades. And then in the one, their original, their satin kind of lipstick, I have four shades. I have the shade, what do I have here? I have La Venue in 1990, and then I have the shade Slip, I believe, and Baby. Incredible. And these are so comfortable, and they do not dry out your lips. This is a, like, more of a soft matte in the way that it feels and wears, the Mera Beauty matte lipstick. And it's, I don't find it super drying, and my lips are always dry. Love these. And then it wouldn't be a recommendations video if I didn't recommend the shade Vegas, specifically from Kosas in their lipstick. I am obsessed with the shade. It is a stunning shade. And if you're looking for a beige nude and you're my complexion and you feel like everything is either too orange, too pink, too ashy looking on your lips, definitely check this out. Again, I wear it with a brown lip liner. I'll wear it with a dark brown or a lighter brown lip liner. And I'm just obsessed with this. And I'm gonna say this, and I know everyone gets sick of me saying this. This was my wedding lipstick, and I feel like that's how you know. It was comfortable to wear all day, and the shade was great. Huge fan. Next, we have some glossy items for you. The Tower 28 lip glosses. I love these. I mean, you can't go wrong. They're really comfortable to wear. This is the shade Pistachio. I also have a few other shades. They're just glossy. They're good. They're good lip gloss. They're not too thin. They give you a little bit of, to me at least, it feels like they're hydrating my lips. I'm a really big fan of this lip gloss. Then we have the Ami Colet lip oils that, to me, I really just wear as a gloss and a lip oil. I am such a big fan of these. So I have two shades here. This is the shade Bliss, and this is the shade Excellence, or I believe it's the shade Excellence. Yeah, Excellence. I have a bunch of shades. I am such a big fan. This is a fresh one. Oh, I'm just obsessed. Let's put this on. So comfortable and so hydrating. I am obsessed with this formula, and I know so many of you are also obsessed with it. Now we're moving on to, like, super hydrating, balmy type lip products. The first one, yes, I have a sickness. Yes, I own three. The Edam lip softening balms. I am obsessed with these. So I have the shade Bisa Glaze and the shade Fig Sauce, and then I also have the clear one, which is Butter Mochi. Is it Butter Mochi? Am I making that up? It feels like something I made up. Oh no, Butter Mochi is correct. Butter Mochi, they're incredible. They smooth out the dusty crusties on your lips. They're super hydrating. They wear really nicely throughout the day. They layer really nicely on top of lip products. They wear beautifully alone. Again, they smooth out the crusty dusts on your lips. And when you put them on, and let's say you're, you know, going throughout, like by the end of the day, like you're reapplying throughout the day, whenever you need, you get home, you still have some on, you remove it. The dead, dusty, crusty skin that needs to be removed kind of like just sloughs off. At least for me, it does. It's incredible. I'm such a big fan of these. Then up next, the Olic Hendrickson Lip Peptide, specifically this one, the one in the orange tube. However, both are great. Like, their tints are great. This one is the shade Cocoa Cream. Oh, I should put this on. I feel like this is a good shade to put on, layer on top. This is such a beautiful shade. Are you kidding me with that? It's so gorgeous. I love it. But out of the two, I find that, I mean, this is like my 100th of these, and I like to have backups. I'm obsessed with this, and I will be buying one during the sale, specifically of the orange, because I find the orange to be more hydrating than the tinted one, but incredible. And I feel like it would be remiss if I didn't suggest the Butter Balm from Summer Friday, so I'm suggesting this because I really do enjoy it, specifically this shade here. This shade, Brown Sugar, is incredible. I'm obsessed, and the pink one, also stunning, gorgeous. If I had to pick between the Summer Fridays and the other ones, I would go with one of the other ones. And if you're looking for something like this, that is just like strictly hydrating and all of that, I would probably go with the Ole Henriksen, the orange one. However, if you want some more tints, they do have the tints in the Ole Henriksen formula. I do think that the Edam ones are more hydrating in the tints. So I would go with the Edam if you want a tint. If you want something that is just hydrating and like doesn't have a color or anything, I would go with Ole Henriksen. But these are nice. They're like right behind them. They're just not quite as good as those. Now we're gonna move on to fragrance, hair, skin, all that jazz. So we're starting with fragrance, and the first one, just Ellis Brooklyn scents in general, but this is the scent Miami Nectar. I'm obsessed with this. This is one that I love on vacation or in summer. And I know it's not summertime, but we're all good. People go on vacation a lot in wintertime, and so I feel like, and a lot of people love a vacation scent. I love a vacation scent, and this is a great one. When I was on vacation in August, I got stopped when I was leaving. Was it brunch or lunch? Lunch or something. One day I was leaving lunch, I was wearing this. I got stopped by two people that worked at the hotel. They were like, "What is that?" And I was like, "Oh, no problem. Let me put you on. This is amazing." I also always, every single time I go and hang out with like my in-laws or something like that, I always get a lot of comments about the scent as well if I'm wearing it. This is amazing. But I also love the scent Salt. I'm reordering that. I also love the scent Super Amber, the scent Myth, and the scent Florist. All stunning. Next up, we're gonna talk hair. And first, I wanna talk hair masks. I love these hair masks from Amika. So this one is the Soul Food one. But I think they changed the name to something. But the Soul Food hair mask is incredible. And then the Cure hair mask is incredible. I love these. My hair soaks these up. I leave the Soul Food one in for about 5 minutes. And the Cure one, 5 to 10 minutes, kind of depending on what my hair needs. But my hair is obsessed with these masks. And it just, my hair is always looking good when I use them. And if you're not a hair mask person, I really like this conditioner. So this is from Amika as well. This is their Cure conditioner. I love this. You put it in your hair for like, you take a breath and your hair is like soft and smooth and perfect and amazing. I don't know what absolute hocus pocus is in this, but I'm obsessed with this. And I'll do this once a week and one of the hair masks once a week. So I switch between the hair masks and I do this all the other days. And then for days like today, my hair's so greasy, I need to wash it. I'm gonna wash it tonight. But when I need dry shampoo, Living Proof, I'm obsessed with this dry shampoo. This is by far my favorite. I have the really, really big one. This is incredible. This is just their original one. I know that they have like more intense ones now, but this, the standard one, is the one I go with. I shake it up and I shake up between each like spray. So I'll shake, spray, shake, spray again, shake, spray, and then let it sit for 30 to 60 seconds. Usually I'm impatient, so 30. Rub my head, and then I will get a brush and just brush it through, and my hair is fine for the rest of the day. If my hair is extra, extra, extra greasy and dry shampoo feels like it's not gonna do anything, I will blow dry kind of and put a little bit of heat onto the dry shampoo, and that makes it work even better. Now let's move on to leave-in conditioner. Leave-in conditioner from The Crown Affair is my obsession of life. I love this. So I do about a pump per side of my head, and it just soaks right in. It doesn't disrupt the style that I have in it or have, you know, done in my hair if it's from like the day before and it's leftover. I just put it in and it hydrates my hair. My hair loves this. It drinks it in. Truly, my hair is obsessed with this, and I don't love leave-in conditioners that are wet and then you kind of have to dry your hair afterwards. I like leave-in conditioners that I can put on dry hair and I don't have to worry about futzling or anything like that. This is incredible. So hydrating. This smells amazing. What's the smell? Let me smells like a really good salon. I don't know how to explain it, but I love this. This is probably my third or fourth bottle of this. I love this, and I also have a bunch of minis for when I travel because this is like a hefty bottle, right? Because it's glass. Then up next, we have the K18 oil. I love this. I do about 3 drops, which I know sounds crazy. Put it in wet hair, let it sit for about, I think it says 4 minutes, and then I can go on with the rest of my products. I do this probably twice a month on the ends of my hair. Twice a month, I would say, on the ends of my hair. My hair loves this. This is amazing. And this bottle, you don't need the full one. This bottle will last me until I'm in the grave. This is going to last me forever. It's amazing. And the ends of my hair really like this. And I feel like I've noticed a difference since about, I want to say it was last year when I first got this. I think it was last year, and I still have what feels like the entire bottle, and I use it twice a month. Then overnight, I make a dream routine. I'm obsessed with this. This is incredible. I do about a pump per side. Again, put my hair up in a low bun, and my hair is so hydrated, feels silky, feels great in the morning. Now, this is a great alternative to the Kérastase, their 8-hour leave-in overnight cream. This is also amazing. And I know this isn't considered clean. However, I feel like I need to mention that I feel like this is a good alternative to this. And it has kind of filled, the Amika has filled the void of the Kérastase. I still love the Kérastase one. And it's amazing, but the scent is very, very strong. And I know a lot of people don't like the scent. The Amika one, this, it's still scented, but it's not quite as perfumey and strong. It kind of just smells like Amika products. This is really nice, super hydrating again. Put my hair in a low bun when I go to bed. Not anything tight, just a loose low bun, and then I'm good to go. Now we're gonna move on to skincare. And the first, no one's shocked. You'd be shocked if I didn't suggest this. The Kosas deodorant is the love of my life. It controls how much I sweat, first of all. I feel like I sweat less when I wear this. It also controls my smell all day. I put it on in the morning, just like that. And then I'm good to go for the day. And then I put it on before bed because I feel like a lot of people don't double deodorize, deodorant apply. And if you feel like you're always like sweaty and smelly and whatever, double apply. For using this, I don't always have to wear something at night, the Kosas Sport. I just prefer it. I just like, cause I sweat at night. So I like to wear this at night because I'm a sweaty sleeper, but I also sweat during the day and I have pretty smelly sweat. I've said this 1,000 times. So this does the job, and specific to Serene Clean, I've also tried the blue one, I don't know the name of that, and the unscented one. This right here, she's my gal, amazing. Then we're moving on to face mask. I'm obsessed with her. The Caudalie Detox Mask, I love this. I've talked about this 1,000 times. I do this on my face when I need it. I don't always need it. Sometimes even if my skin's in a good place, sometimes, you know, once I get to the end of the month and I'm doing my like, oh, should I do some face masks or whatever to kind of round up the end of the month, sometimes I'll be like, oh, my skin's in a good spot, but we're gonna make sure it stays this way. And so I'll do the face mask, I apply it. It's really easy to remove, which is why I love this, because some clay masks, a chore to remove. This one is not. It's amazing. And then underneath all my face creams and all of that, before I put serums on, I really like this. The Caudalie Grape Water. I know a ton of you tell me you love this as well, which makes me so happy, but I love this. I spray this on my face and then I'll go on with serums and whatever else I'm putting on my face that day. And I just love it. My skin really likes this. It's a nice mist. It's really comfortable. Let me show you the mist. Now that's a mist, and that's a nice mist. I am a really big fan of this. And yeah, that's it for my Sephora sale recommendations. I would love to know down below, are you grabbing anything? Are you avoiding the sale? Let me know down below. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.